In this video, we're going to practice using the comparison test to prove whether a series converges or diverges. Let's start with a series k equals 1 to infinity of 3 over k plus 2. That means that our a sub k is 3 over k plus 2, and we need to come up with a b sub k that we can compare it with. Well, when I'm looking at this a sub k, it makes me think of 3 over k. And 3 over k acts like the harmonic series, right? It's just a constant times the harmonic series. So the series 3 over k diverges. So if we want to compare that with 3 over k plus 2, if we want to show that 3 over k plus 2 diverges, it would have to be bigger than 3 over k, because we already know 3 over k is going to partial sums are going to go to infinity, so does 3 over k plus 2 partial sums go to infinity. Unfortunately, this isn't actually true. When we add 2 to the bottom, we are actually making the bottom bigger, which makes the fraction smaller. So 3 over k plus 2 is, in fact, smaller than 3 over k. So we want to find a different b sub k that we can compare with a sub k. What if we try 1 over k? Will that be smaller than 3 over k plus 2? 1 over k will be the harmonic series, so we'll know that diverges. All right, so let's try this. Well, we're going to do something a little bit clever. We're going to say that 2 is less than or equal to 2 times k when k is greater than or equal to 1, which it will be for our series. So now let's add k to both sides, because we really are interested in k plus 2. So k plus 2 be less than or equal to k plus 2k, which is 3k. But now if we know k plus 2 is less than or equal to 3k, then we can divide both sides by k, because k is always positive, and also divide both sides by k plus 2. So we have that k plus 2 less than or equal to 3k. We divide both sides by k times k plus 2, we're going to get that 1 over k is less than or equal to 3 over k plus 2, which is exactly what we needed. We're allowed to do this because we know that k is positive and k plus 2 is positive, so dividing both sides by k and k plus 2 did not change the inequality. So now that we're done playing with inequalities, we can state that the sum k goes from 1 to infinity of 1 over k diverges because it's harmonic. Therefore, the sum k goes from 1 to infinity of 3 over k plus 2 diverges by the comparison test. Let's try another example. Let's look at the series. K goes from 2 to infinity of 5k over k cubed plus 8. So we look at this and we think to ourselves that when k is big, we know that, you know, thinking about growth rates and such, that we only are going to care about the leading terms on this rational expression, a sub k. And so we're going to know that when k is big, a sub k is approximately 5k over k cubed, which would be approximately 5 over k squared. So we'd like to compare with 5 over k squared if we can. And we know that the series k goes from 1 to infinity of 1 over k squared converges, because it's a p series with p equal 2. So if we want to try to show that our original series converges, we want to show that this series is smaller than something else we know that converges. So let's see if we can show that 5k over k cubed plus 8 is less than or equal to 5 over k squared. Now, I wish I could tell you that there was a definite way that you should check these inequalities, but sometimes you just have to figure out something to start from that you know is true, and then see if you can figure it out. So if I wanted to reason through this, I need to figure out some way of stating this. So what if we divide top and bottom of 5k over k cubed plus 8 by 1 over k? Then we would get 5 over k squared plus 8 over k. So now we're comparing 5 over k squared with 5 over k squared plus 8 over k. So when we're adding 8 over k to the bottom, that's going to make k squared plus 8 over k is always bigger than or equal to just plain k squared. So when we put them in the bottom of the fraction, 5 over k squared plus 8 over k, putting something bigger in the bottom makes the whole fraction smaller. So we have the inequality we were hoping for, that 5 over k squared plus 8 over k is less than or equal to 5 over k squared. Off to the side here, I'll show you another argument that you could make. You could say 0 is less than or equal to 40, so 5k cubed is less than or equal to 5k cubed plus 40. So 5k cubed divided by k cubed plus 8 is less than or equal to 5, which means that 5k over k cubed plus 8 is less than or equal to 5 over k squared. And of course, this only works when k is greater than or equal to 1, but since we only care about k greater than or equal to 1, that's fine. I prefer this way over here, though, because to me it seems more intuitive. With this one, you had to kind of start with something random and do a bunch of algebra and just happen to figure out. And it's not really random, right? If you started with this, you could algebraically go backwards, figure out what you'd need, and then turn around and write the steps again forward. And that's what a lot of times what people do with these inequalities. In fact, that's what we did here, right? And with this method, we said, oh, well, we would need this. Hey, this is true. So when we flip it over, we get the inequality we want. Okay, so then we can state that the sum k goes from 1 to infinity of 5 over k squared converges, again, because it's a p-series, p equaling 2. So the sum k equals 2 to infinity of 5k over k cubed plus 8 converges by the comparison test. Note that it doesn't really matter that we went from k equals 1 to k equals 2 here, because all that matters when you're talking about convergence of a series is the tail of the series. So as long as we know that the series converges eventually, no matter where we start, it's going to converge. Let's try another example. Let's look at the sum k goes from 2 to infinity of 1 over k squared natural log of k. So we want to figure out something to compare this to. This one's a little trickier. So this kind of looks like, it makes me think of 1 over k squared. Because this ln of k, I know from growth rates that ln of k doesn't contribute as much as a k to a power. So I want to think about, well, what does that ln of k actually do? So what do I know about ln of k? Well, I'm going to be multiplying it by k squared. I want to compare maybe with 1 over k squared. So the question is ln of k bigger than or equal to 1? And ln of k keeps getting bigger, right? So when is it bigger than or equal to 1? Well, ln of e equals 1, and ln's increasing. So ln of something bigger than e is like 2.7, so ln of 3 is greater than or equal to 1. So what does that mean? That means that if I take 1 over k squared and I multiply it by a number bigger than 1, like ln of k on the bottom, I've made the bottom bigger, which means I've made the entire fraction smaller than it was when it was just k squared. But this only works for k bigger than or equal to 3. But again, if the comparison works eventually from some point on, then that's good enough, because with series we really care about, you know, just the tail. So we can say that the sum k equals 3 to infinity of 1 over k squared converges, because it's a p series, p equals 2. And then we can say, so the sum k equals 3 to infinity of 1 over k squared natural log of k converges, by the comparison test. So then we can say that the sum k goes from 2 to infinity, 1 over k squared, natural log of k, converges. Because you can add terms to the beginning of the series, and that doesn't change whether it converges or not. Let's look at another example. This is the sum k goes from 2 to infinity of 3 plus negative 1 to the k, all over the square root of k minus 1. So we know that negative 1 to the k flip-flops between negative 1 and 1. So what does that tell us about the top of our fraction? It tells us that 3 plus negative 1 to the k, if you add 3 to all these terms, flip-flops between 2 and 4. So that gives us some information about what's going on the top of our fraction. On the bottom of our fraction, we have square root of k minus 1. And we know that square root of k minus 1 is going to be less than square root of k. Why do I care about square root of k? Well, if I had a square root of k on the bottom, that would be a p-series. That's something I know how to deal with. So I can use this information to say that 1 over the square root of k minus 1 is bigger than 1 over the square root of k. Now, of course, this has to make some sense, so we'll say k bigger than or equal to 2. Otherwise, we'd be dividing by 0. So what can we say? We can say that 3 plus negative 1 to the k over square root of k minus 1 is bigger than, well, we know the top is the smallest is 2, so it's bigger than 1 over square root of k. So maybe we should write that in here. Since 3 plus negative 1 to the k is bigger than or equal to 2. So now we have a comparison of our a sub k with another sequence, v sub k, 1 over the square root of k. And we're saying that our a sub k's are bigger than this, but we know that this series diverges because it's a p series, p equaling half. And so since we figured out that our series is bigger than that one, we can say that our series diverges by the comparison test. Okay, let's try one last example. This is the sum k goes from 1 to infinity of 1 over k squared minus 5k plus 1. Now here, we know we want to use the comparison test, but we want to be a little bit careful because our comparison test says that all terms are positive. But for a sub k equaling 1 over k squared minus 5k plus 1, this is actually negative for k less than or equal to 4. So we're going to look at the sum k goes from 5 to infinity. See if we can do something with that. Because remember, if we can show that it converges from 5 on, then adding a finite number to the front isn't going to change it. Now, what do you think we want to compare this with? Well, again, this seems like it's going to behave like 1 over k squared when k is big. But if I ask you, is 1 over k squared minus 5k plus 1, is that going to be less than 1 over k squared? Because we know 1 over k squared, when we sum that up, it's going to converge. Is that true? Well, we're subtracting stuff from the bottom. That makes the bottom bigger. So no, not necessarily. So what else could we compare with? Well, what if we just increase the number on the top of the fraction? What if we compared 1 over k squared minus 5k plus 1 with 2 over k squared, or any other, you know, constant that you like, but let's try 2. Well, now this is a little more difficult, because how do we decide if this is actually true? Well, is this true? I don't know. We know that k is positive, though, so let's move it to the other side. K squared over k squared minus 5k plus 1, is that less than 2? I'm still not really sure. But I know that k squared minus 5k plus 1 is positive for k bigger than or equal to 5. So let's move that to the other side. K squared less than 2 times k squared minus 5k plus 1. Let's simplify. And remember, this is all question marks. We don't really know if it's true yet. And distributing that 2 out, we get k squared less than, maybe we hope, 2k squared minus 10k plus 2, which is then, by adding k or subtracting k squared from both sides, 0 would be less than k squared minus 10k plus 2. Okay, so when is k squared minus 10k plus 2 positive? Well, we're adding 2, so that's only going to make our answer more positive. So we could ask ourselves, when is k squared bigger than 10k? Well, what would we need? We would need k to be bigger than 10 for this to be true, bigger than or equal to 10. So this is very confusing. So I've been just doing some algebra, seeing if I can figure out something about whether this inequality is true. But let's try to take our work and turn it around now. See if we can make an argument that makes sense. So let me erase this. And I'm going to start over here, and I'm going to go through the steps backwards. So let's assume that k is bigger than or equal to 10, because remember, if we can do this eventually for the tail, doesn't matter about the first few terms. Then I could state that k squared is going to be greater than or equal to 10k, right? Multiplying both sides by k, k is a positive number. Then I could state that 0 would be less than k squared minus 10k, just subtracting that 10k to the other side. I could even say less than or equal to if I want. And then I could add 2. You know, that's not going to make this side any smaller. It'll make it bigger. So that's still true. Now I could add k squared to both sides again. I mean, why would I think to do this? Well, I'm just following my own work, right? So here I'm going from this line to this line. How did I get from here to here? How did I get from here to here? I subtracted k squared. So let's add it back. And then let's factor out that 2 that we had foiled back in. And now you can start to see where this is going to go. Divide both sides by k squared times k squared minus 5k plus 1, which we I've already checked that k squared minus 5k plus 1 is positive for all the terms we care about. And simplifying then is going to give us 1 over k squared minus 5k plus 1 is less than or equal to 2 over k squared, which is what we want. So this is an important technique in general when you're dealing with inequalities. Start with an inequality that you want, like this one. Do algebra. And go down the page, figure out what you would need to have to get that inequality to be true, and then argue it backwards, saying, if I start here, then everything else I want is true. So now we have our inequality, at least when k is greater than or equal to 10. So I can state that the series k goes from 10 to infinity of 2 over k squared converges, because it's a P series with P equal 2. So then the series K equals 10 to infinity of 1 over K squared minus 5K plus 1 converges by the comparison test. Therefore, the series K equals, where do we want to start again? Oh yeah, we wanted to start at 1. So K goes from 1 to infinity of 1 over K squared minus 5K plus 1 converges. Because it doesn't matter if we just add a few, you know, finite